So I'm joined here today by Kerry Ryan from the Brighton Vegan Activist, and we're going to be talking about veganism.
Yeah.
And firstly, I know your organisation recently held a protest outside Brighton University. Can you just tell us what that was about?
So we sort of stood outside Brighton University to raise awareness about the vivisection animal testing that's going on in the uni and in all unis around the country at the moment. 50% of animal testing takes place inside universities, and it's not something that's widely known, so we were making it aware to the students and the public.
And just on that issue of animal testing, I mean, how widespread is that now? Because obviously there was a lot of campaigning, particularly in the 80s and 90s. So for cosmetics, I think a lot of people think that animal testing's actually gone down significantly. But is that the case or not?
It's illegal in the UK at the moment, but a lot of companies will take it to China or somewhere like that to animal test because it's cheaper, but it's not actually a very effective method. But 50% of the animal testing for scientific purposes goes on at universities at the moment.
And is that for medical purposes, that animal testing? Because that's the only thing that's legal, is that right?
Yeah, the universities are for medical testing and for curiosity. So I think they're just, you know, curious about scientific experiments and stuff, but it's not actually beneficial to humans, those ones.
And what are the alternatives to animal testing? So obviously you were campaigning at University of Brighton, but what would your message be to all universities that are testing on animals?
There are a lot of alternatives, like using like stem cells and stuff like that, using computer technology, human volunteers and stuff like that. And it's not actually a very viable way to get the results you want. A lot of the experiments that go through animal testing then don't work on humans, and there might have been some that would have worked on humans but got stopped at the animal testing that could have benefited, you know, illnesses and stuff. So, our end goal in the end is maybe to try and get these universities to consider using alternatives if we raise awareness about it.
Okay, and just lastly, where can people find out more information?
Well, about our activist group, we have a Facebook page, Brighton Vegan Activists, and Instagram as well, I believe. But if it's more about sort of veganism, there's a few things on Netflix. Cowspiracy is about the environmental impact of eating meat. Earthlings is on YouTube, and more recently, there's a documentary, it's only 45 minutes, called Land of Hope and Glory, and it's about, it's all footage from farms in the UK in the last 6 years, and they are ones that are labelled Red Tractor approved, RSPCA approved, sort of free range, and it shows the reality of what goes on. If anybody's having trouble going over to a vegan diet, there's a website called Challenge 22 where you can sign up for 22 days free consultation with dietitians and recipe advice and a forum where you can post your questions and stuff about veganism.
Great. Okay, Kerry, thanks for coming today. Cheers.
Thank you.